numbers. Here we go.
That's your new ritual against Kirby.
Yeah.
8 seconds.
Coming.
Thank you. Bobby.
Nine orange.
Two.
Thank you.
I got it.
Thank you.
Zach and I grabbed a cheeseburger. I know some of you heard me earlier. I'm sorry, I didn't know I was supposed to have two different talks and realize it'd be the same team again, but this is the last night for basketball, and I am so happy that everybody's been able to play. No major injuries or anything like that, but it's good to have you with us, and I want to say thank you to Craig. I know this is kind of your brainchild, and you've worked hard to make this possible. I should have said that earlier. I want to tell you guys something. Craig, he has put this together from the beginning, not just to play basketball, but with a mind to make sure that on a consistent basis, people would play basketball, but also hear the gospel and to have opportunity to rub shoulders with guys that love Jesus. And so it's awesome. I know most of you know who I am. I'm Pastor Jeremy. I'm the pastor here at First Baptist De Soto, senior pastor. And you know, this is the last night, but I thought I would spend the last night talking just a little bit with you about matters of first importance. Today, I had a long talk with a 44-year-old widow whose 45-year-old husband died. They declared him dead, actually, Sunday evening. And so that was a real sad afternoon to spend with a family grieving. Also, got home from that visit, got back to the office, actually, and one of my dear friends, one of the first people that I led to the Lord, led to salvation in Christ, called me and told me that he has pancreatic cancer. We had just ordained him a deacon of his church there in Southern Illinois 2 weeks ago. And so, one of the things that my friend Terry told me this afternoon was, he said, don't fail to share with people the urgency. To take advantage of every chance you have to share the gospel. So that's kind of where Paul's at here in 1 Corinthians 15, one of my favorite passages. This passage deals with the resurrection of Jesus Christ, but before he gets into the resurrection, he talks about the gospel. Hear these words. He says, "Now I will remind you, brothers, of the gospel I preached to you, which you received, in which you stand, and by which you are being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I delivered to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas and then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers at one time, most of whom are still alive, but some have fallen asleep." So friends, if you have one message to tell somebody, that message should be the gospel. The good news of Jesus Christ. It is the message in which we all stand. It's the most important message in all the universe. And I think it's interesting, the language here, Paul says, the gospel which I preached to you, which you received. The gospel is something that is achieved by God and received by us. We cannot save ourselves. We can only receive the salvation that God has given us. And he tells us what that is, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures. So the first step that you need to remember is that no matter who you are, you're a sinner. Everybody in this room is a sinner. But the good news is, the gospel is that Jesus died for sinners. And this is all according to the Scriptures. In addition to that, he was raised on the third day. He was buried and raised on the third day. So the good news is that Jesus not only died for us, but he gave us the hope that we too would live forever with him, that we could be resurrected just as he experienced the resurrection. All that we read about in this Bible, everything points to Jesus. The Scriptures point to Jesus, and the hope we have is Jesus. And so I just want to share with you guys the truth that means the most to me. And I just want to ask you, you know, how often do you think about how much more time you have? Now, watching you guys run out here, some of you are breathing heavy. You might not have much more time at all. I don't know. Chris, it's looking rough, Chris. It's looking rough. but in all seriousness, we take for granted that we're always going to have another day. And I just want to share with you guys, many of you in this room, you love Jesus and you know Jesus. But I don't know how desperate we are in sharing Jesus. I don't know how consistently we're, every day, we're thinking about how important this is. Paul says it is a matter of first importance. And so let me just ask you as we wrap this up, is there any evidence in your life today, or was there any evidence in your life yesterday, or the day before, or maybe the day before, is there any evidence that the gospel is of first importance in your life? Was there anything you said to anybody? Was there any kind of action in your life that showed that the gospel is the most important thing? Because most of us go through day after day after day. And if people were to say, okay, you know, I'm looking at you, looks like the most important thing is, what would they say? Your job, your family, all fine things. But would they ever say the gospel? What is the matter of first importance in your life? And is there any proof that it's this, that Jesus died according to the scriptures, that he was buried, and that he rose again on the third day according to the scriptures? Paul says that's the most important thing. And if you believe that, I'm going to ask you to live it. Let's pray. Lord, we don't know how much time we have. Life is a gift. And I pray, Lord, that you will help us to prioritize you, your gospel, your truth. The world needs you. The brokenness and the darkness of the world can only find its healing and can only be illuminated by you. And so, oh Lord, I pray tonight that you will help us to live our lives in such a way that when people see us, they know what's most important to us, you. And we pray this in Jesus' name.
Are you ready?
No.
Are you ready? so you're all right. You all right? Okay.
Green ball. Green ball. Going that way.
Thank you. Mike, I got Mike.
Lift with that.
Same team!
Ball. left.
Thank you.
Hey, DC, and time out. Player, call. Get the guy over there. Green's coming this way. Green's coming this way. Orange going that way.
One green. Five.
I got it.
5 points, I grabbed.
Yeah, let him get it.
Thank you.